All right, I want to talk about something that I find personally very fascinating. I have not made a decision either way, but let's talk about Antarctica and the whole possible flat Earth theory that Antarctica is actually an ice wall that goes around a flat Earth rather than just a ice cap at the South Pole. And I know this is a hot button topic. This is one of the few ways to get conspiracy theorists to argue with each other because people are very divided on this. I can say I was completely against the flat Earth idea until I started doing research and looking at the mathematics of both. But like I said, I haven't decided one way or another. But have you heard about this? Have you heard about Putin?
Putin could spark territorial free-for-all in Antarctica by threatening to rip up the treaty? The Antarctic Treaty? Wait, the treaty that stops everybody from independently exploring Antarctica? That's right.
So if you're not familiar with the Antarctic Treaty, you need to look it up and read about what it is, and ask yourself why the heck all these different countries of the world agreed on this. What's the deal? It's very suspicious. And I kind of think Putin might be looking for the truth, just like we are.
Yo, for those of you that are still skeptical, or shall we say asleep, and still, you know, don't believe that the Earth is flat, that there's more beyond Antarctica, go ahead and look up Admiral Byrd and his diaries. If you're still believing that the government is not poisoning us and feeding us more meds to poison us, go ahead and look up John Rockefeller's writings. If you still don't believe that we are so powerful and we can literally manifest anything and we even have telekinesis powers, go to CIA.gov and look under declassified documents.
NASA is a big fraud.
So another big area watch where they lie faces to us when continuously and they've been taking our money from the very get-go and they've conditioned our kids is NASA and the space agencies. NASA had a partnership with Disney a very long time ago. NASA was created so that it could look like we'd go to the moon because we'd never had a photo of the moon before. So they were telling us we lived on a spinning globe with no evidence. So that was the reason why we went to the moon. If you just look at it and look at the lies continuously that come out of their mouth, then you'll see that that is about to come out too. People hold on to space travel because it's what we've been growing up with, all the programs we watched and all the things we learned at school. And then I've got all these science books that show me all these little marbles and cartoons and CGI characters, and it all makes us insignificant and worthless and meaningless. That's the whole idea of it. And we're gonna see those truths start coming out too.
Let's talk about how it's 2022 and the elites haven't went back to the moon yet. First of all, the first moon landing was absolutely fake. What we have to understand is that the elites, the government, NASA, they're all in, under the same umbrella. They lied to us for money. NASA get billions of dollars off of us by telling us that we live on a ball out in space, when in fact the Earth is flat. It's just a few things that I want to point out about the supposedly first and last moon landing. I want you to look at this picture of the moon. You see how bright it glows? It just sends all this bright light across this realm that we're living on. But what happened to the glow of the moon while they were supposedly landing on it? There's no glow. Why is it so dark in the background? Here's another photo. Just take a look at it. Do you truly believe that the moon looks like this? I don't. And again, if we can see the moon glow so bright here from this realm, why is it so dark right here where he's standing? And look to the left. I mean, why is it so dark on the moon? And they expect us to believe that they sent this thing out of space and they were able to drive on the lunar rover on the moon. Just look at this thing. It doesn't even look like it moves. And is those lawn chairs sitting on top of it? I'm not falling for it. And if you are a Christian, it clearly says it in the Bible. I'm not religious, but this is one thing in the Bible that I do believe. Just read Psalms 19:1. And this guy right here was one of the founders of NASA. Before he died, he dropped a jewel. He left Psalms 19:1 on his gravestone. That's not a coincidence. Guys, we have to look between the lies that the government has told us. All of our history that they're giving to us is not the truth. That's why it is important for us to read and do our own research and find out things for ourselves. And most importantly, use our intuition and logic and think for ourselves. It's time to break away from the matrix and wake up. One reason why they won't go back because they know that we have technology as well. And it's a lot of us, somebody like me, that's gonna look deep into what they're doing and point out their bullshit. They can't set the stage to do that bullshit again because they know that it's a lot of us with our eyes open. We can see the bullshit that they're trying to pull. And they don't want to be called out on it. Wake up, guys. Wake up.
Hey, NASA. I'm just wondering, when are you going to lend some of that handy-dandy technology to the phone services? Because we can't get a phone signal at our house. Never mind the desert. You keeping a signal with a satellite 7 million miles away, though, huh?
You have got to understand that there are consequences to your actions.
You are like Papa!
You don't find that suspicious? You don't find that suspicious? You don't find that suspicious?
Being flat makes more sense than Joe Biden being president.
Moon landing.
Hate conspiracy theories because I embrace facts.
Oh, he got bar bars.
Let me give it a try.
A conspiracy theory is only a theory until it's proven to be true. But you only see what the new spoon feeds you and only hang with sheep like you. Now, I'm not gonna say that every theory is a fact, in my opinion should only matter to me. But don't attack somebody else because you lack the mind power to wrap it around the possibility. Let's go. You see, the world that we live in is truly up, so I don't push it past anyone. I look without a biased view. I leave the judgment up to you because it seems like you try to troll for fun. So let me give you what you want. I shed light on your flawed logic because apparently that's something that you lack. Just because your pretty little brain can't fathom what I'm saying doesn't mean that it can't be a fact.
You still think the earth is flat?
Sure do.